This is me subjecting my brain to elevated CO2.
Can't focus.
In this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is for you to lower your cognition by 50% from this silent assassin. That's right, it could actually kill you. But more commonly, it would make you feel tired and perform poorly driving, working, or studying for your exams, even in your sleep.
I spent $360
and hours of research and experimentation so you don't have to. And man, this video changed the way I live because the readings from this device shocked me. And when you finish this video, you'll become empowered to know 4 steps you can take to improve your cognitive function by becoming aware of how quickly brain-altering levels of carbon dioxide can rise indoors. It all started when I watched this video.
We're nearly there. So I am 50% dumber because you've been breathing so much.
After hours of research, this was the craziest statistic. Cognitive function scores were 15% lower for the moderate CO2 day and 50% lower on the days with 1,400 ppm. So I began my quest to test the 2 most common places that can affect our cognition, our cars and our bedrooms. Put my device in my car and was shocked at how quickly the CO2 increased. This means 15 minutes in your car could decrease your cognition by 50%. And who knows what 30 minutes does to you? And if you're thinking to yourself, hey, it's not like I'm doing math in my car, what's the big deal?
Wrong. It could potentially save your life.
This study showed focused activity level.
Oh, it's focused.
And crisis response, skills needed for driving, plummet at increased CO2 conditions. No wonder there's so many dumb drivers around. 20 to 30% of all car crashes are caused by drowsiness, and high CO2 levels are known to cause drowsiness. So it's fair to say that recycling your air in your car could actually affect whether you have a crash or not. Here's the surprising part. Did you think that opening the door, stepping out, and going back in would flush out the CO2? Think again.
Let's see the results.
The simple act of closing and opening the door does a little difference to your CO2 levels in your car. Now you're probably wondering if the AC in your room is the same. The answer to that is... But first, let's see how much carbon dioxide builds up overnight with no AC and no windows open. And it was bad, but not as bad as I thought it would be. I figured it's probably because of the cracks beneath my door, the ventilation shaft, and this spinning whirly thing, whatever it's called. Now with the AC on, I was actually surprised. It did help to an extent. Carbon dioxide peaked to about 1,000. Still not the best, but hey.
Hey, but you're just sleeping. You're not doing anything cognitive, right?
Turns out studies found sleep with elevated CO2 made people more sleepy and score less on their logical thinking tests the next day. Hey, just because I'm Asian doesn't mean I dream about complex equations, okay?
E equals MC squared.
I put this to the test with my whoop tracker and found that during nights with no ventilation, my slow wave deep sleep was less than average compared to the nights where my windows were open. So after days of research and testing, I came up with 4 simple hacks to decrease your CO2. But before we go on, please like and subscribe to this video to push this video out to more people. You can help spread the message so that you could help someone's chronic fatigue and even save a life. So number 1, open the windows and quit the recycled air. Using this option maintains the CO2 at the 500 level, which is ideal. Save the recycled air for the tunnels or if there's a car in front of you farting. And how about work? I forgot to open the windows, but luckily here I noticed. So I opened the window, but nothing really happened. It was only here when I opened a window on the other end of the house as well that it began to drop. So that's the next tip. People are often scared that plants in their bedroom would release more CO2 in the nighttime. While it's true CO2 is released by plants in the nighttime, overall the net effect is that there's a decrease in CO2 throughout the whole day. CO2 is not the only thing that affects our health as well, as there are many toxins in the air that can affect you too. So having air purifiers will help maintain your health. A cheap way of doing this is actually having indoor plants. This study by NASA found that certain plants can actually decrease deadly cancer-causing toxins in your house. These are the plants that are particularly good. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.